Hello, my name's John Lomas. We're here at the BCG workshop. It's our second workshop. We had one in October. We're going to have a great day. I've got three things I'd like you to do today. Firstly, have some fun. Secondly, take some good pictures, maybe pictures you can use for your camera club competitions. And thirdly, learn a few things. Now, we've got some really great models and we've got a number of lighting setups. There's three lighting setups here inside the hall and we've got three outdoor lighting setups. We're going to have six helpers and they'll take you through it, and I guarantee you, absolutely guarantee you, you're going to come away with some winning pictures. The format of the workshops goes something like this. At the beginning of the day I give a PowerPoint presentation which lasts for about 35 to 45 minutes. Following that we have a morning tea and then we break off for the fun part, taking some pictures. The first part, we call it session one. And that's where we divide into six groups of about five or six people each. And each of the six groups has a team leader. And the objective is to photograph each model, each of the six models, and also photograph at each of the six locations, meaning three indoor locations and three outdoor locations. And each session goes for 25 minutes. So at the end of about an hour and a half, every workshop attendee will have photographed at least six models at the six workstations. So, and be given some guidance by people who have the experience in using lighting. So it's a really great opportunity, session one, to make sure you get a cross-section of the work that's available to be got. Then we have lunch, and session two is a really great session because that's the free-for-all. And that's where you can photograph what you want, where you want, and the models have changes of costume, often something a bit more outlandish, shall we say, a bit more exciting. And that's where we can really experiment and be creative. So often the very best pictures come at the end. And that's with most portrait sessions. The best pictures come towards the end because we get better, we're more comfortable. The models are more comfortable and we're more comfortable as the photographers. Here on Saturday night, a number of us came here and we were setting things up. Things don't happen by divine intervention, so thanks to Vince Cesari and Paul Stevens and others for coming here, and Rodney Lawler. We did a lot of work getting this place ready for the workshop on the Sunday morning. And there's a lot of behind the scenes activity goes into these events, particularly on the model side of things. I have to pay tribute to our model director, Chloe Lee. We actually select from about 30 or 40 models to have a diversity of models of different types, male and female. Particularly models have got the experience in front of a camera. People who don't need a large degree of being directed by, you know, amateur photographers. So the models really play a part in making it easier for you, the photographer, at these events.
Hi, my name is Chloe. I'm here with the Brisbane Camera Group today on our lovely workshop. Please excuse the makeup. I've just taken off a lot of dried blood. Not real, but fake blood. My role here today is I've helped to organise the models and just to give a bit of direction, a bit of styling, then jumped in front of the camera myself. You know, just make sure John's not stressing out. We have six amazing models and we've all been working very hard today in this 34 degree heat to get the shots for the attendees.
We have three indoor setups in the hall here, and basically we're using continuous light sources. We're doing this purposely because using continuous lights, many people can shoot at the same time, as opposed to when you use studio flash, you need a trigger and it's more or less one person at a time. So for the learning exercise benefit, continuous lights are the way to go. Having said that, these continuous lights are fairly weak. They're daylight fluoros, but inside here, you'll probably be using a much higher ISO because of the relatively weak power of the lights. Also behind me here, you'll see a background. We have three backgrounds here. Now a background, as far as an indoor studio goes, is somewhere between something and nothing. It's there, but we don't want to make it too sort of outlandish. So at our workshop here, we have a black background, a sort of a grey background, and a textured canvas background. And they're all really great backgrounds, and they really complement the model. And one of the things about backgrounds is, as I was saying, you don't want to really know they're there. The model is often about 1 to 2 metres at least in front of the background. And by rule of aperture and that, the background will go very much out of focus. We have three outdoor locations at these events, and one of the main things about the outdoor locations is using that big light in the sky, the sun. And at many times the light can produce very hard, dramatic, almost ugly lighting. And one of the things we encourage people at these workshops to do is to modify the light, to take bad light and turn it into good light. We often talk about hard light or hard-edged light and soft or soft-edged light. And by using diffuser panels, we can actually make a miraculous change in the quality of light. Also, for the outdoor sessions, we have some use of reflectors to fill in light, to reflect the sunlight back into the face of the models. We also use LED lights as a little kicker to sort of highlight the shadows. So there's lots of things you can do outside to turn bad light into good light. And that's one of the key learning exercises from these workshops. Well, thank you for coming along to our workshop today. Doesn't time fly when you're having fun? Now, I know you've taken hundreds of, collectively, we've probably taken tens of thousands of images. And I know there's some winning shots amongst them. And I'm sure you've learned something today, whether it's about lighting, hard light, soft light, whether it's about wide apertures, longer lenses, some aspects of posing. So if you've gone away learning, knowing one extra thing, then I'm happy that this has been a successful workshop. So thank you for coming.